Hi, good afternoon. Susanna Kunkel with PhillyLiving.com. Our conversation today is about agency, and I'm going to share with you a couple of mistakes that I've made when I made one of my first home purchases that you can learn from. I bought my first home with my fiance in the 90s before HGTV and Zillow. Always had a passion for real estate, going back to making Barbie houses out of cardboard when I was a little girl. And, so I'd been watching the market. I loved our neighborhood where we were renting and went to open houses consistently. I was watching the market shift. I think I had a pretty good finger on the pulse of good opportunities. I was seeing them go quickly. Read a lot of books about real estate investing. I felt pretty confident in my market knowledge. So when I saw this house at the price they wanted, I said, this is it. I dragged my fiance to the first open house. We were excited. There were multiple people there. We told the agent we'd like to make an offer. She said, great. Met at her office, signed the stack of papers. She helped us with the lender. And she told us that we beat out a couple other couples. So we felt special. But in reality, in 2004, when I was getting my license, I flashed back to that experience and I realized that I knew it was dual agency because she was representing the seller. I didn't really know what that meant or the term, but what I also didn't factor in is she also was the seller. So after when I got my license, I realized that we never had a discussion about that. We never had the agency discussion that we have every time we meet a client first time. And also, there were things that we didn't know a buyer agent would have told us about. We didn't have a home inspection. It had knob and tube wiring. It was a redwood house built in the 30s. Loved it. Now, we were protected, coincidentally, by an escalating market. The dot-com bubble came. We sold in 2001 for almost three times what we paid for it. But in a normal market like Philadelphia, it's really critical that you know what your rights are in the home inspection, the due diligence, and you have some help and guidance through the process of not only negotiating up front, but getting it to settlement. And that's the part that is not often talked about. It's not the sexy part covered on HGTV. So the second mistake I made, which you'll have a picture to laugh at me about on my blog article, has to do with the analogy I often use meeting with buyers, is your agent is your navigator going down the river to whatever your destination is, be it a new home, new investment. You always want to understand what your goal is. Now, just like river rafting, the river looks calm at first, and it can be easy to underestimate the critical nature of who, the roles of who's on your team, your lender and your realtor can make or break getting down the rapids. And that's another story, but as you see in the picture, the last rapid, Devil's Run, due to not a good team member, the boat tipped and I fell out and actually took somebody with me as we're falling out into the rapids. So I want you to have a laugh on me and understand that when we meet, I'll go over what you can expect in the home buying process, some tips for success. Of course, I hope to be your agent of choice, but after our meeting, you can be assured that you will be more knowledgeable about the home buying process, some critical steps along the way, and what you can, I'll point out what's around the bend in the river, so to speak, and how you can prepare for that and arrive safely at the other shore.